Okay, welcome back to the channel of Promenzo Vids, and tonight's video is my thoughts on the signing of Blaize Talagi for the Panthers on a 3-year deal from the Eels, starting from next year until 2027. So it's a big signing. Like, obviously for a couple of weeks now there's been talk that Blaize Talagi will be looking for a new club. I mean, not too long ago Parramatta confirmed his release and that he has decided to leave the club and find a new club for next year. He's done that. He's found the Panthers as the next suitor for his signature, and what a pickup! Obviously, Blaize Talagi's got a huge future in the game of NRL, and yeah, I think he'll be the Panthers 5-8 next year. I'm assuming he will be, with Jerome Luai departing the club. So, when you think of a Blaize Talagi and Nathan Cleary combination for the Panthers, boy, as a Panther fan, you must be so excited, because yeah, wow. Obviously, Talagi's the whiz kid still, but then Cleary's the, you know, the masterpiece in that team, the real leader as the halfback. So yeah, I think if you're a Panthers fan and you've realised that you've got Talagi for a long term deal and how good he already is, you'll be excited, and as you should be. But before I get to my full thoughts on the video, please be sure to like this video and do subscribe if you haven't already. Reached 4,600 subscribers, so happy about that. I guess I'm on to 4,650. That's my current goal. And end of year goal, 5k, hopefully. But yeah, that's all for later on. But more importantly, enjoy the video. And yeah, here is my thoughts on the Blaize Talagi to Panthers signing. Gee, I just don't know how Parramatta can keep losing like really good juniors, because it seems like Parramatta have always had great juniors in their systems, but just cannot keep them for whatever reason. And I feel like Blaize Talagi is another one that could be a victim under that as well, because yeah, I mean, obviously Talagi is still a work in progress and still is a young kid that is definitely developing his game. But from what I've seen, when he's played on the wing or in the centres, like, he's just showing so much potential. And, you know, he's a pretty strong body, definitely runs hard and has a lot of skill. You know, a lot of people will say that Talagi is a bit overhyped at the moment. And look, fair enough, because he is young and needs to back up what he's doing now into next year. But I think at the Panthers, that's where his game can go potentially to a whole new level. I guess the only downside is that he is playing in the halves, and for a young kid in his second year of first grade, it is a bit difficult to move out of a less pressure position, which is wing and centre, which he's been playing at Parramatta, to go to a main role at 5-8 for the Panthers. It's a big role, but what helps him is he has a lot of champion players around him, so it might be okay, but it's just a very big move for a very young kid to still put it that way. But yeah, but look, I think Talagi's going to suit Panthers pretty well. I think, yeah, obviously disappointing for Parramatta to lose yet again another junior, but I think when you think of how good Talagi can be and how good the Panthers already are as a club, it's a pretty exciting duo, and you can't lie about that. I guess it does leave guys out like Jack Cole, who was supposed to be the original replacement for Luai, but that seems to be out the window now with Talagi coming. Brad Schneider could have been an option too, but I think he was always sort of depth for the Panthers. And Zane Laurie was also talked about as an option to replace Luai, but I don't think Laurie is really much of a starting 5-8, for my honest opinion anyway. I think he's a good backup player. But yeah, look, Talagi is going to be huge for the Panthers. A lot of skill, definitely can see him representing, wouldn't say Australia, I mean, he can, because he was a former schoolboy for the Australian side, but I think more so for Samoa first, because yeah, I think Samoa has that sort of nation. I think that's a bit of an easier route to get to and play for, so I could see him playing for Samoa one day in the World Cup or whatever, or even during rep round. But yeah, I think for, you know, Talagi and his sake, I think it's a good move for him. You know, I am keen to see how he does go around guys like Cleary, Leota, Dylan Edwards, Vizza. Like, he's in a world-class team. And I know Penrith have lost a fair bit of talent over the years, but they've still got a really, really strong team and a real mad bunch of players. And yeah, that's going to be awesome to see how Talagi goes around all that. As for Parramatta and how they replace him, look, it's going to be interesting, because they are now short of an outside back. I think the outside back positions are the weakest point of that Parramatta team, because obviously Guffo and Moses are the mainstays in that team. So is Dylan Brown in the halves. But their whole back five, apart from Guffo, is just not safe, I reckon. Or apart from Pennicini. But I've heard Sevo might be going. Sean Russell's a bit hit and miss. You know, Jake Tango is probably just back up at best. I don't know. It's a tough one with Parramatta and what their best back five is looking like next year with Talagi going as well. But I'm sure they'll work it out. But yeah, look, it's a big signing for Penrith. This kid has it all, and I'm keen to see how he does go in a champion system next year. But what do you make of the Blaize Talagi signing for the Panthers? Do let me know in the comments down below if you like it or not. But as always, like, comment, and subscribe, and have a good night.